The H-2B visa program, also called the Temporary Labor Visa Program, allots 66,000 visas across two half-year cycles for companies in the United States to hire foreign workers on a temporary basis. Usually, during the summer, another 20,000 visas or so are allotted for a total of 86,000 visas. At least, this is how things have been forever. In 2022, that all might change. To find out how an unprecedented surge in H-2B applications in the first half of the 2021-2022 fiscal year is going to impact your business's chances to get foreign workers, and to figure out what you need to do to be competitive, come back after the break. You're watching Log Rate. This is the channel where I give you reliable information to help you make better decisions and avoid costly mistakes when interacting with the US immigration system. Today, we're talking about the H-2B visa, which is one of the sub-themes of this channel. Specifically, we're talking about the April 2022 cycle, which is gearing up and getting ready to go. My name is Damjan Denoble. I'm the managing partner of fronteraTECH Law. We used to be called Bull City Lawyer if you've seen some of our older videos. Over the past 6 years, I've gone through this cycle twice a year. Our law firm has helped hundreds of companies navigate their way through this complex application system for the H-2B visa. Before I go on, if you want some more information about the H-2B visa cycle and you want it for free, do check out the guide that we publish on our website. You can find the link below in the description. It's free to download, and of course, it has all of our contact information in here. Our law firm, again, has helped hundreds of firms navigate this process over the past half decade. Despite all of our experience, I have never seen what I've seen in 2020 and now in fiscal year 2021-2022. Traditionally, the H-2B visa has been for seasonal businesses like fish manufacturers, landscapers, hospitality services, and even restaurants in busy tourism locales. For that reason, the H-2B visa remained a pretty niche visa as far as the larger US immigration system is concerned. Over the 5 years that I've been doing this since 2016, definitely the H-2B visa has popped up on the radar more and more every year as there seems to be a perennial worker shortage. Let's look at a few more reasons why this glut is being anticipated by me with such certainty. To start with, every industry is affected. The most basic components of all businesses in the United States have to do with supply chains. And the most basic component of a supply chain, arguably, are the transport companies that make it go. Whether it's ships or it's trucks, we need drivers and we need crew to move our goods all around the world and all around the country once they arrive on American shores. Trucking companies cannot find enough workers in the United States. Even if they could find enough workers, it might be impossible to train everybody in time to relieve the glut. So they are looking at the H-2B visa anew as one potential option for them. Certainly, I think the October 2021 cycle applications are going to reflect this reality. Likewise, construction companies are facing a giant boom in their industry. That's good, right? Well, it's good, except there's not enough supplies to build the houses that there's great demand for. And those construction companies lucky enough to have a good supply chain that's bringing in the supplies that they need, even at elevated prices, well, they're hitting a second hurdle. They don't have enough workers. So they too are doubling down on the H-2B cycle, which for them has been a traditional source of workers. But it's not just those two big categories. Landscapers are seeing a boom for their services. Everybody's at home, right? All these new houses are being built, right? Well, what about cleaning services? Great demand for cleaning services in our COVID times. And then we're eating more than ever before. Fish factory operators, they're in a boom, but again, they don't have enough workers. And you can go on down the line and hit every big H-2B industry. Everyone needs more workers than they've ever needed before. Throw on top of that industries which haven't been in the H-2B cycle traditionally, and now you have a crush on this particular visa. The second component of this is a bit ironic. The flag system, which was instituted in 2019, it was touted as a new way to file for the prevailing wage and the temporary labor certification. It was supposed to bring together all these state workforce agencies and the central processing units of the Department of Labor. And in my opinion, it worked. Ironically, however, remember I said there's irony, it worked all too well. The FLAG system became so easy to use that it no doubt contributed to an increase in applications, which perhaps was an intent. Even though last season saw over 96,000 visas requested for a cycle that only allocated 33,000 to US employers, the October 2021-2022 fiscal year cycle has increased from the previous year by 100%. Understand that this is a big deal. In 2021, the April cycle, which saw 96,000 applications, just to reiterate one more time, was artificially suppressed. I say this in hindsight because I definitely didn't see that this year, which I'll talk about. The fact was that 2020 COVID-19 policies by the previous administration suppressed foreign worker demand artificially. There was great demand for workers among businesses, because we were already seeing the same staffing shortages in 2020 that we're seeing now. But restrictions on the H-2B visa meant that a lot of employers simply could not apply. The October cycle last year, that is the October 2020 cycle for the 2020-2021 year, seemed to be in line due to this artificial suppression with increases that we saw between 2017 and 2018 and 2018 and 2019 in the H-2B visa. The April cycle, though very high, and though it saw a jump, was still, in my opinion, artificially suppressed. When we look at the October 2021 cycle, which again had a 100% increase over the 2020 cycle, I think we have a good idea of what we're going to be seeing in April 2022 for those requesting H-2B visas. Even if we assume that the previous April cycle was not completely suppressed, I think we're still looking at a 50% increase in applications from the year before, meaning that instead of 96,000 visas being requested, we're going to be seeing somewhere closer in the range of 152,000 spread across anywhere from 7,000 to 10,000 employers. This has profound implications for what you need to be doing to prepare your business for being successful in the H-2B visa lottery. And yes, just like last year and the year before, 2022, April cycle H-2B visa applicants are going to be facing a random lottery. In our guide, we lay out the fact that there are about 12 steps in the April 2022 H-2B visa cycle that you have to undertake before you can get a worker. And in fact, you have to get through the first two steps in order to be eligible at all, because as I said before, there is a lottery. The first two steps, the prevailing wage and the temporary labor certification, are very time sensitive. In years past, even last year, I would have said, hey, get your prevailing wage in before the start of December. I'm revising that this year. This year, I'm saying, get your prevailing wage in November 1st, at the latest by November 15th. This is because, simply put, you can put your prevailing wage in 150 days before the starting date of need. Your starting date should be April 1st. It's not going to be any farther than April 15th, because if it is, simply put, you're not going to get a visa. But more to the point, even though prevailing wage determinations, even through the excellent online FLAG system, which is where you apply for your prevailing wage and your temporary labor certification with the Department of Labor, it's supposed to take 3-4 weeks. In reality, it's taken 4 to 6. So if you want to get your prevailing wage back in time, especially anticipating a crush on that system and a crush on prevailing wage determination workers, you need to get it in ASAP. My fear is if you get it in after November 15th, it simply won't be returned to you in time to apply for the H-2B visa lottery, which takes place from January 1st to somewhere around January 5th every year. Last year, it was January 1st to 3rd. The year before, January 1st to 5th or so. And we'll see how many days we get this year to apply. It could even be a 2-day window, depending on how many applications are anticipated. I hope you understand now why the 2022 April cycle is going to be so big. There's going to be 150,000 applications. That's my guess. Those applications are going to come steamrolling in as soon as the gates open for even the prevailing wage determination. And then if you don't have a robust action plan, you're gonna get left in the dust as you get notice of deficiency upon notice of deficiency. Even the best in the business get them. Even I get them. In fact, I get them all the time, not because I don't file robust things, but because the process is rigorous. But what professionals can do and what those who are prepared can do is respond quickly and not lose much time on their application. If all of this makes sense to you, if some of it makes sense to you, do give us a call and do subscribe and check back for the next video. Over the next month or so, I'll be covering the H-2B visa cycle exclusively on this channel. Thank you so much, and I hope to see you soon.